I'm sitting in the corner with silly fat friends, waiting for the doom watch, they're waiting for the end. Wife is in the kitchen, sitting there in the dark. I'm out in the big world, surrounded by sharks. I need a best friend, or she'll never let me down. I need a best friend, or she'll never let me down. I need a best friend. She'll never let me down. Let me down.
But I think she's got a very beautiful face. I love her face, actually. And I can't really do her justice, to be honest. I think she's got such a wonderful, warm ambience. She's a very tolerant and loving person. It shows in her face, I think.
Did you write some songs about her?
Yeah, sure, several. Yeah.
Oh, I need a best friend. She'll never let me down. I need a best friend. She'll never let me down. So I'm waiting for someone to knock upon my door. Tell me you're all right. Smile once more. Come into the kitchen. Make a cup of tea. Say everything all right, Kevin. That's the one I need. I need a best friend. She'll never let me down. Oh, I need a best friend. She'll never let me down. I need a best friend. She'll never ever. She can't ever. She would never ever let me down. Never let me down. Never let me down. Never let me down.
Maybe I subconsciously blame music for the state I've been in, you know, I don't know.
That's an interesting idea. Yeah.
I think in a way I did. But I loved, I love music, and I think my son made a good point the other week when he said, you know, for him, most people, it's 95% of their life is nothing to do with music. It's only a fraction of their life, but for somebody like me, it's almost my whole life, really. Because I think in musical terms pretty well all the time, and in visual terms, but of course at that time, instead of music, I started painting, and I was producing hundreds of paintings, and writing. I wrote two or three books during this time, and so much of my energies went into that direction.
Was it the proof that you could do without music?
Not really, I don't think so, but then again, subconsciously it might have been, I don't know, but I discovered I could make money from pictures and live from art, probably live from art, and so I concentrated on that.
Do la 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 do
Yeah, this arrived today. I think that's a basilitz on the front there. But just a picture of something like Steve Erlangen's just done this book. And there's one of my pictures in it. But it's next to a Picasso, which is rather nice, I think. I'm not such a sociable person these days as I was, you know. I'm not, I'm not a guy for partying and rushing around. I used to be, but since I stopped drinking and then I stopped smoking, you go out and you feel a little bit out of place somehow.
People sometimes say the artist, as a heavy drinker, is very inspiring.
This is bullshit, really. I think I might have thought the same, you know, but, I was reading a piece. I mean, there's so many of these great people like Dylan Thomas and Ernest Hemingway and all this, and most of them either committed suicide or drank themselves to death. And maybe they say, oh, they were geniuses, this was necessary for them to be that way, but I don't subscribe to this at all. I think that's an illusion, really. I think you do far better work without it. Although, I have to say, the stuff I did in the 70s on record stands up very well today.
Marjory Razorblade, what a picture she made in her long and fusty dress. And the hair that she plaited best. What a woman, what a tongue. What an abrasive manner. And if anyone upsets me, let it be because she's mine. Though she's over 59, she's experienced of the world far beyond my years. Mother me, Wallop, Marjory. Razorblade, mother me Marjory, Razorblade, mother me Marjory, Razorblade, mother me Marjory, Razorblade. Go!